formally welcome you to this session and to ask you how you've been able to cope since March when the lockdown happened.
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon.
My name is Lekan Balogun. I'm the CEO of Macquarie Clothing.
Okay.
We thank God since the beginning of this COVID-19 pandemic. Can you hear me, sir?
I can hear you. Go on.
The whole world has been operating differently, and the future is really looking uncertain to so many businesses. But to the glory of God, one thing I believe, I belong to this school of thought, which says change is the only constant thing.
Okay.
I'm a fan of change, whether planned or no planned. So whatever, anytime something new happens that I'm not even expecting, I try as much as possible and adapt to any situation I find myself. That is one of my things. So I take things the way they come. You understand?
Yeah.
So it is not a very, nobody was expecting it. It was uncalled for. Nobody saw it coming. I mean the pandemic.
Yeah.
But it started, I think the lockdown started sometimes in March. And I was at home for like almost 8 weeks without doing anything. Right from my banking years, you understand? So,
sorry?
I'm a workaholic. I like to work. People call me Mr. Machine. I don't like
okay. We can't hear you.
Can you hear me now?
Yes, it's better now.
I said I like to work because I believe if I work, I'll make money.
Okay.
You understand? So people call me workaholic. They call me Mr. Machine because I like to work.
Okay.
So for like 8 weeks, I couldn't do anything. I wasn't doing anything. I was just at home, sleep, wake up, which is not the normal thing for me. Because of the lockdown, we could not go out, you understand? Even if you have to go out, just have to go out to the market to go get something to cook in the house.
Okay.
So it has not been easy. But there is always a saying as well that every difficulty, there is an opportunity. You know,
yeah.
An opportunity. Behind every difficulty, you have an opportunity. So
yeah.
The kind of opportunity I got during this COVID-19 lockdown, while I was at home, gave me opportunity to sit back, re-strategize, rethink, rejuvenate, and think about what I can do to make my business grow. Because is that we like it or not, this COVID-19 pandemic has come to stay. It's looking like a normal sickness now, like a malaria. You understand? It's looking like HIV. It's looking like, so it has come to stay. So whether you like it or not, and this is the only thing we know how to do. Fashion business. That is the only thing I know how to do after leaving my banking job for this business. So to the glory of God, after the lockdown, the first stage of the lockdown, I got to my office. I called some of my managers. I called them for a meeting. We had a meeting and we're like, okay, what can we do? We talked about, you have to continue to pay bills no matter what. House rent, office rent, you have to pay staff salary. Hello, can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you now.
So, like I said, the only thing that is constant is change. And
okay.
We are ready for it. We need to adapt to the new normal. And the kind of...
What's the new normal now for you?
The new normal is, this is COVID-19, you understand? So, people need to at least adapt to this change that we're seeing now. It's not ready to leave us anytime soon. So, what can we do? And again, Nigerians, the kind of customers we keep, Macquarie, I'm speaking from my own point of view. The kind of customer we keep goes a long way. The kind of relationship you have with your customer goes a long way. My customer, the kind of customer, they just want to look good, parties or no parties. You can imagine what the COVID-19 actually cost everyone. Fashion shows were shut down, events were canceled,
yeah.
No wedding, nothing. And this is where fashion designers get their money from. If you are not making clothes for wedding, you are making clothes for an event, you are making clothes for one for a red carpet event and blah blah blah. You understand? So and all these things are not happening and they are not looking like they will happen again this year. So what can you do? We have We have our online platform. We are online centric. We have an online platform that we sell. People don't even need to come to our office to order for our stores. We started innovating. You understand? We have a new kind of innovation that we have to just input in our business. And the kind of I'm trying to avoid the car.
Okay. So,
this is what we are doing. Innovation is what we are doing. And whichever business you are doing, as long as you know what you are doing and you know you identify your target market, you know the kind of customers you are dealing with, you won't feel it much. You understand what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
The kind of customer we maintain are customers that just want to look good. They don't want to be cut on fresh. They want to look good. They are attending party, they're not attending party, just want to look good. And this is why McCoy is here, because McCoy clothing, McCoy denotes the real thing. So we are here for them. And to the glory of God, after the ease of the lockdown, business has started picking up. We are doing our thing, we are doing our best, and our customers are just the real MVP. They don't want to leave us because of the fact that the relationship we maintain with them. Relationship is very, very key in whatever business you are doing. And that is what I've been able to learn where I was working before, which is the banking industry. You understand? So relationship is very, very key. So when you have a very good relationship with your customers, they check up on you, they call you from time to time. How are you coping? What's going on? What's the new thing? What can I wear? You understand? I can't remember the last time people wear Agbada now. Most people wear Agbada to events. People are not making Agbada like before. But they still want to look good. They want to go out. It affected business in one way, but yet, to the glory of God, we are still there, and this is what has become part of us. Most of the clothes we make now, because everybody, you can't walk on the road without using your face mask. So whatever clothes we make in our office, in our company, we tell as much as possible and do a face mask that will match the clothes, you understand, with it.
Okay.
So you can always look like that, you understand. For example, this Akaya you're putting on now, if I don't make something like this for you, the remaining pieces can be used as a face mask for you. So you understand. So anytime if you are wearing a white dress tomorrow, you have a white face mask that you can rock with it. So just like that. So honestly, it's been God. I will not lie to you. God has been wonderful and God has been faithful. I have some of my colleagues that are still complaining up to now that business are not coming.
But so you mentioned some keywords. Innovate. What are the other key points again?
You have to re-strategize.
Okay, re-strategize.
You need to rejuvenate yourself.
Okay.
Because this thing has come to stay. It's not leaving us anytime soon. But yet, people don't want to look. Nobody wants to go out naked. You still need to wear clothes. You still need to look good. Nigerians love fashion. Nigerians want to look good. Fashion industry has come to stay in Nigeria. Take it or you leave. We have a lot of fashion designers who are doing well in Nigeria. So we are doing good now. Fashion designer, if you know your onions, this is a very lucrative business. You understand? It's just a pandemic that wanted to give us a setback. You understand? So sometimes it's in business, in life, you need to take a step backward. Do you understand? Before you know, okay, let me proceed. So it's a lesson to everybody. It's a lesson to every businesses, not just fashion designers alone. We have celebrities now, they are not attending shows. We have MCs, they are not going to shows. Musicians, they are not attending shows. I understand a lot of Nigerian beauty, they are not doing any show this year. You understand? So it's not something that is easy. And this thing even taught us to at least try as much as possible to always think outside the box. Don't finish all your spending, you understand? If you make 100 naira today, put 50 naira somewhere, spend another 50 naira, maybe put it back to your business, you understand? It's always good to think outside the box. I think that's what I have to say.
Okay. I was also going to ask you, do you think that business is going to go back to what it was before? We shouldn't just look at that again. It's a closed... The past is the past, as it is. I'm wondering what your take is on that.
I understand. Like I said, I'm very sure and I'm confident that business will still go back to normal. Because, take it or leave it, this COVID-19 will not be here for 100 years to come.
You understand?
Just like Ebola, Ebola came and left. But COVID-19 is very, very stubborn. I don't know why. It's very, very stubborn. It's refusing to go now. Everybody's walking down the street with their face masks and all that. In fact, police are arresting people. If you don't use your face mask, they will arrest you. You understand? So let us just have it in mind that at least in the next 1 or 2 years, it can, you understand? It will go and everything will come back to normal.
Okay.
I miss attending parties. I miss attending functions. I like to party. I like to attend functions. And it's not happening.
I've also noticed that you also dress very well. And I was wondering, is it something that has always been part of you from when you were young or when you became a designer?
Can you come again, sir?
You've always been a good dresser. And I'm wondering, at what point did you decide to start dressing well? Is it something you grew up with or is it something you developed?
Exactly. It's something I grew up with. My late dad noticed that in me when I was very young, you understand? That was what prompted him to say, okay, I want this guy to go and learn fashion design because I'm very finicky in whatever I want to wear. And I'm always very particular about whatever I'm wearing. I don't want to be caught on fresh. I like to look good. Do you understand? I like to look good. When I was in banking, the way I dress, most of my colleagues that were together in the branch don't dress that way. I always dress to kill. You understand? I always dress to kill. My tie is always very slim. My shirt, the way I talk in my shirt, the way I wear my pants. You understand? That is what I like. I like to always look good. Because I don't know. I might be here now. As I'm talking to you, somebody can just call me. McCoy, let's go and see Buhari. I won't tell the person, let me quickly go home and change my dress. You understand? I want to follow you the way I am. That is me. So it has always been part of me since the childhood.
How easy was it leaving the bank for fashion business? At the time you did.
Like I said, I don't know whether you remember this in my last interview with you, maybe 2 or 3 years ago. Yeah. I think the only regret I have now is not I've not resigned for the because I left banking 7 years ago. And the only regret I had since then was how come I've not resigned earlier? You know, because I believe it is an open market. A lot of people want to showcase their talent. Do you understand? I believe if I had resigned earlier, in fact, I would have even gone far than where I am. But with the glory of God, I still thank my God. I'm a force to reckon with when it comes to fashion design in Lagos here in Nigeria. You understand? So this is what I've been doing even before joining banking. I told you, August 3rd next month is going to be my 20th year in this 20 years anniversary. 20 years anniversary, yes.
Okay.
I've been doing this for a very long time when I was very young. I got the name McCoy Clothing.